All right, good morning from another fabulous day here in Las Vegas. Looks great outside. I think we're going to head over to Bigelow Aerospace. Let's talk today about the Bigelow B330, which is an inflatable habitat that Bigelow wants to send to space to make it easier to build structures and get them up and running as fast as possible. I don't think they're going to let us in, but we'll go over there anyways, and maybe we'll just look at the sign and we'll talk about it. So we made it to Bigelow Aerospace. I tried to go inside. We emailed them a couple days ago, but unfortunately, this was kind of short notice, so they didn't have anybody available to show me around. But inside, this is where they build the B330, which is an inflatable habitat that they want to send to space where astronauts and potentially even tourists could go live and work in space. Now, the B330 is about 330 cubic meters in volume, which is where it gets the name from. And it's designed to be a fully functional inflatable habitat. It would start in a very small state so that it could fit on top of a pretty skinny rocket like a Falcon 9 or an Atlas 5 or something like that, launch into space, and that's where they could inflate it and actually get the full volume available for astronauts. Now, one of the main things that Bigelow is focusing on is the Lunar Gateway. It should be no secret that NASA is trying to get astronauts back to the moon by 2024. One of NASA's plans is to get a pretty stripped down Lunar Gateway in place, which is really just kind of a tin can that has a power module attached to it where astronauts could transfer from their spacecraft to a lander and then go land on the moon. Eventually, NASA wants to expand that and have a livable habitat where astronauts could stay a little more long term. Right now, NASA's plans for the Lunar Gateway are pretty short term. They actually need a visiting spacecraft to provide life support. But the Bigelow B330 would be able to fill a lot of those gaps and provide long term habitats for astronauts. And Bigelow is pushing pretty hard for this. They've told NASA that they could have the B330 ready to fly in as little as 42 months. Now, that quick timeline is pretty essential for NASA, especially since they're trying to get astronauts on the moon by 2024. So they're pretty much ready to go, and they're pushing hard to actually get this thing in lunar orbit. The B330 isn't limited though to Earth orbit or lunar orbit. I mean, this thing could go anywhere. As long as it can generate power from the sun, it could provide a livable habitat for astronauts pretty much anywhere in our solar system. One of the forefront items that it could potentially be used for is if you take two of these B330s and hook them together, it could be used as sort of a transport habitat from Earth to Mars for astronauts that are on long duration missions. Now, the B330 is packed with features already, including things like radiation shields to keep the astronauts safe. One of the things that it does not have, though, is windows. Kind of a bummer. If you're going to space, I would want to look out the window, see the moon, see the Earth, but they do have room for kind of curved TVs so that astronauts can at least see a picture of what's happening outside. One of the original ideas that Bigelow Aerospace had for the B330 was to actually attach it to the International Space Station and then start sending space tourists to the International Space Station that could live in the B330. At the moment, though, it seems like Bigelow does not have plans for that, though, particularly because of how hard it is to kind of coordinate that. There are so many different agencies that are now running the International Space Station that they would have to coordinate with like 11 different legal departments just to set up the infrastructure needed to get tourists onto the International Space Station. Additionally, as of right now, just to get astronauts up to the International Space Station, people would be paying something along the lines of like $50 million for a ticket up to the space station, live in the habitat, and then back down to Earth, which trying to find a customer that's willing to pay $50 million for a ticket, there's probably not a lot of those out there. Now, if you were to compare the B330 habitat to like the International Space Station's Destiny module, the Destiny module is about 106 cubic meters compared to the 330 cubic meters of the B330. The Destiny module is about 15 tons in mass and the B330 is 23 tons. But what that means is that you get 210% more volume for only 53% more mass. Now, one of the concerns that you might have is if it's an inflatable habitat, how robust is this this going to be for ballistic materials and space junk that's out there? And Bigelow has said that the actual B330 is more prepared to handle that sort of ballistic impact than actually the International Space Station is. In order to handle that, it basically has about 24 to 36 layers of material, and when fully inflated, it's still about 18 inches thick. It's designed to have two solar arrays, two thermal radiators for heat dissipation, as well as life support systems to sustain a crew of up to 6 astronauts. It's also got things like a zero-G toilet with solid and liquid waste collection, semi-private berths for each crew member, exercise equipment, a food storage and preparation station, lighting, and a personal hygiene station. So this thing has got it all. Now, Bigelow is designing the B330 so that a variety of spacecraft can dock with it. They intend for the Soyuz to dock with it, the Orion capsule, Crew Dragon capsule, the CST-100 Starliner, so they're prepared for everything to be able to dock right directly to the B330. Now, the designs and the plans for the B330 started off as the original Transit Habitat, which was NASA's development project in the 1990s to develop a habitat that they could use to transport astronauts from Earth to Mars. That program, unfortunately, had tons of cost overruns and delays. Congress eventually passed a resolution banning NASA from spending any further funding on the development of the Trans Habitat, and Bigelow purchased all the patents and development work that had been done thus far. Now, Bigelow Aerospace and the B330 is one of 5 companies that are developing habitats for NASA to use as part of the Lunar Gateway. Ultimately, NASA is going to evaluate all these design considerations and choose probably just one contractor to actually build it. All right, I am super excited to see what NASA decides, who they decide to go with. I think Bigelow has really got a shot at this with their B330. All right, it is crazy hot out here. I gotta get back in the car. See ya.